What's going on, man? I'm Santi here from King Santi Productions. I got two very good boxing analysts sitting here with me today. Boxing journalist Manuel Santiago. Alias known as Manny. And I got D'Lo here, former fighter for the Platinum Gloves. I just want to go ahead and get started here. The two topics for today is Amir Khan and Guerrero. They both had, one of them had good showings, the other one didn't. So I just want to ask you guys a couple questions. You guys are boxing experts and see your opinion. I want to ask you first, Manny, this one. If Amir Khan would have beat Danny Garcia, do you think he could have moved up in weight after a beat with Zab Judah and Lamont Peterson and stuff like that? Do you think that he would have had his big payday with Pacquiao, or was it an overrated vision?
It was overrated, honestly. Amir Khan's been overrated since day one. But he was going to move up either way. I think he's going to move up now regardless, because he can't make 140 anymore.
So you don't think he should have deserved the Pac-Man fight?
Pacquiao made one, which is the one he was going for.
Okay.
He doesn't deserve either one of them.
All right, sounds good. Question number two, I'm going to come at you with this one, D'Lo. You saw the Amir Khan fight.
Yeah.
Why do you think he was knocked out? Do you think he just wasn't prepared? Do you think he underrated Danny Garcia?
I think he underrated Danny Garcia. Not only that, his mentality was just to go there and destroy him. And that, you can't do that against an undefeated fighter like himself. The kid is hungry. The kid is not only, you know, from Philadelphia, who has a slick style of fighting, man, but he was coming in there for a reason. And I was to do exactly what he did and knock him out.
I remember in the pre-fight, they were both talking about knocking each other out. So Danny Garcia made his promise. I don't know about
everyone. A lot of people don't remember. Amir Khan was supposed to fight Lamont Peterson in their rematch, and the week before the fight, Peterson got busted with PEDs, men's substances. So he did a whole training camp, and then after the training camp, when he was getting ready to fight, the fight was dropped, and 2 weeks later, he was back in training camp. So that's making any excuse for him not saying it to away from Danny Garcia, but he was a little overtrained, honestly.
Okay. Well, this is both of you. I'm going to go ahead and start off with you, Manny. Question number three, and last question for Amir Khan. Do you think his career has a chance for a comeback?
I don't think so. I think he's done as a prize fighter. He's been knocked out twice, one in the first round by Prescott when he was undefeated, and now he got knocked out by Danny Garcia. He's been hurt by Maidana.
So you don't look at Amir Khan as a prize fighter?
No.
What about you? Do you think his career has a chance for a comeback?
I don't think it has a chance for a comeback, but for a couple of more paydays, yes. He's still young. He's still able to do what he knows how, what he's been doing for a long time. But as far as fighting big names, I don't think he's going to be able to be in there with the Mayweather, with the Pacquiao's, with, you know, upcoming fighters as well. With two losses in his record, I don't think he'll be able to... be considered as a serious prize fighter.
I agree. So moving on to the topic of July 28th, Guerrero, had his battle with the Staden. The first question is, it is a very interesting question, actually. Do you think that Guerrero's personal battles outside the ring, as far as, his wife getting leukemia and, with the injuries and stuff like that, do you think that backtracked his career a little bit, or do you think he's where he's supposed to be?
No, I think that motivated him. I mean, he was fighting for his wife, she was battling cancer, and she had a transplant done to her, and he was hungry, man. He just moved up in weight. He's been running after Mayweather for a while. I don't think he gets a Mayweather fight. He might, but I think that motivated him. He was just hungry in there.
Okay. For you, D'Lo, how good was he in his last fight? Does that make him a contender at all? Or do you think it's just a comeback fight from his injuries and all that?
I think it was, I didn't get to see the fight, to be honest.
Okay.
But, I think...
as far as what you heard from his performance.
The kid could do it. His wife, with his personal life, outside of the boxing ring. That could have did, damage mentally.
Mm-hmm.
Or it could have motivated him, like he said, I don't know. I didn't get a chance to see the fight, but,
Well, do you think he has a chance of coming back?
Yeah, he's going to come back. I think he was under the
contender. Was this a contender? I know this was for the interim.
Yeah, he was in, but he's been the challenger for the WBC title for a few years now. He was a challenger for Berto. The mentor, Berto, didn't fight him. He fought Ortiz. Ortiz didn't want to fight him. He went for the Mayweather fight. They both ignored him, and now Mayweather moved up to fight Cotto at 154, which I don't blame him at all. It's all, you know, I think he's not a big name. But he's been in the run. He's been in the picture for about two to three years now. So
okay,
you got a fighter like that, and you and Guerrero's moving up two weight classes. He went from 135 to 147. And
he was actually dropping a lot of belts in the middle of the whole controversy as well. So the final question the world wants to know, my personal opinion is no, not yet. But should Robert Guerrero should be allowed to fight Floyd Mayweather?
I think so. I think so. I mean, it's a
It's a good fight for Floyd to come back.
For Floyd to come back again. I mean, I'm not gonna say it's an easy fight, but it's a very winnable fight against a good, solid opponent, respectable name.
It'll be a good fight for Guerrero, biggest paycheck of his life. But right now at the 147 weight class, there's too many names, big names that come way before Guerrero. We got Tim Bradley, who really didn't deserve that belt they took from Pacquiao. Pacquiao deserves a chance at Mayweather's title. Mayweather's first defeat, I believe is going to be either him or, I can't think of his name now, but it's too many names to even mention that could come before.
Man,
Guerrero.
Just made a comeback.
Yeah.
I see.
It's,
I mean, that's pretty much what I think, man. I mean, it's a good fight for Floyd. It's a good southpaw to get into. You know, for a man that's trying to get motivated like Guerrero after all his problems, I don't think he should make this a prize fight right now. I think he should give it another year or two. And by that time, it was probably not going to be fighting. So that was, you know, it's good to get you guys' opinions on this. We'll keep this doing every week and see what we can come up with. This is Danilo, guys. We appreciate him. Former prize fighter for the Platinum Gloves. We got boxing journalist Bruno Santiago here. And
StylesMakesFights.com.
Check him out, StylesMakesFights.com.
Styles with a Z.
And he makes the possible interview that he got with Miguel Cotto on Sunday. If we get it in there, we'll check it out. We'll interview him later for it.
I got an interview with Miguel Cotto and two undefeated Puerto Rican fighters. Orlando Del Valle is a 122, and Jonathan Gonzalez, 154, both undefeated, both have big fights coming up.
Sounds good, and check out his boxing articles as well on Styles Makes Fights, StylesMakesFights.com. Follow him on Twitter, Journeyman28, and keep you up to date on all the boxing news. Danilo has Facebook if you want to add him. Check him out, ask him for his opinion, and I'm Kinsanti, at Kinsanti27 Twitter. You know, follow me. What you gotta do, I'm boring. Sometimes I'm fun. It just depends. We won't get D-Lo on Twitter as soon as we can.
Probably tonight.
We'll get you updated. We're gonna get D-Lo's gonna try to get back in the training camp hopefully soon. We'll get him going, and his boy's gonna be father, so we're gonna do it big. King Sound.